To make the Windows 11 interface better and add more features, you only need 3 programs: WinToys for basic optimization, WinHog for customization, and PowerToys, an official Microsoft utility that expands Windows functionality. These programs are light and don't use much resources, and I showed the performance numbers at the end of the video. Let's go! Let's start with WinToys, which you can easily download from the Microsoft Store. In short, it's a super basic optimizer. I downloaded it after installing Windows to do the following. In performance, I turn off background apps, activity history, indexing, and delivery optimization. I also turn off everything in game settings. In display settings, clicking this button will open performance options, where I turn off all settings except these 4. Yeah, this will turn off all animations and the Windows shadows, but Windows feels so much faster without this stuff. In health, I'm telling you for the future, here you can clean junk files from the system. For now, let's turn off background app updates and co-installers. In tweaks, for desktop, I set these options. For the start menu, I turn everything off, and for file explorer, like this. I basically turn off all telemetry related to privacy and, of course, ads. And in system, I choose these settings. In apps, you can also remove various junk software, but that's up to each person. For now, we can restart and continue. WinHog can be downloaded and installed from the official website. The program has many modifications for Windows, but to keep it simple, I suggest fixing just the worst part of Windows 11, the Start menu. To do this, you need to install Windows 11 Start menu styler. The settings already have several pre-installed themes. I've been using this theme from WinStar for some time. There is a version that's joined with the taskbar or a regular floating one. You just need to copy the code and paste it here in advanced mode settings and save. Make sure the code doesn't paste twice or you'll get a JSONG error. So, why this theme? First, I just like it, and second, it works normally, unlike other themes from the web. Okay, the start menu is clear, but for those who are interested, there is also styling for the taskbar in the same style, in 2 versions, with semi-rounded and fully rounded edges. The theme is installed the same way as for the start menu, except the code needs to be pasted in the settings of the matching mod, which is Windows 11 taskbar styler. There aren't that many changes, of course, only the round glow of buttons and islands for widgets and try buttons stand out. But together with this start menu, it's already look much better than the standard design. You can also add to this by going into personalization settings. First, set same cool wallpapers for Windows desktop and lock screen. For example, I really loved nature pictures, especially in high quality. I've been collecting a small collection like this for some time, and I'll share it in the video description. In the start menu settings, you can basically turn off all this stuff and instead add the folders you need. These buttons will also kind of add a bit to the new start menu. And in the taskbar settings, I turn off the search and taskbar view buttons, because I don't use them. I prefer quick keyboard shortcuts. Yes, I know that personalization settings are only available on activated version of Windows. Activation also gets rid of annoying watermark on the screen and makes working the system much more pleasant and smooth. So you can buy an activation key at the good price in the off-store shop. Choose the Windows version you need and make sure to provide your email when making the purchase, because the activation key will be sent to it. You need to copy the key, then go to Windows Settings, Activation, and apply the key here. And that's it, Windows is activated forever. What I use every day, especially for work, is the File Explorer. I already applied some settings for it through WinToys, like the trash bin button. But here's what else I do for my comfort. I open settings, and here I uncheck these 3 boxes, so that often open folders don't show up in the quick access by themselves. Next, in the view settings, I personally like the compact view, when extra space between folders and buttons disappears. I also turn off the status bar. It doesn't really give me any useful information. And of course, I remove the network button, because I, like many of you, never use this feature in my life. Speaking of view settings, maybe someone didn't know about this, but to set up how files look in File Explorer, for example, I like list view, and to apply this setting to all folders in the system, you need to open folder options again, and in view, click apply to folders. Next is a useful tip if you, like me, often connect external drive to your computer. In the This PC window, right-click, go to Group By and More. In this window, check File System, and now choose Grouping by File System. Now, when you connect external drives, they will show up separately from the main volumes. And the last thing I do for my comfort in File Explorer is quick access to work folders and materials. So I unpin all folders from the left panel except desktop and downloads. By the way, quick access to documents, videos, and so on is available here and in the Start menu. As I said before, instead of these folders, I add my own. And to make them look less boring and just easier to find and tell apart, I use the Windows 11 icon pack. They install like this. Open folder properties, customize, and change icon. Then just choose the icon you need in ICO format. And I would finish with File Explorer here, if not for the File Explorer Styler mod in WinHack, which changes the File Explorer header. It's up to each person, I never force anyone, but I personally really enjoyed the minimalist version. But there's an obvious minus here. There is no address bar, which is still needed from time to time. So, as an option, there is a version without the command bar, which I don't use at all, except for initial setup. The last step is PowerToys, which you can download from the Microsoft Store or on GitHub. This program has many features, and over time there are more and more of them. So I leave all of them for you to check out. I'll just point out the ones I use myself. For example, Always on Top lets you pin windows above over windows using a quick keyboard shortcut. Color Picker is a tool for picking colors from any element on the screen, which is super useful for me when editing and designing. Fancy Zones is a handy feature for organizing windows on your desktop. You can create your own layout and holding Shift drag a window into the right area. You can also stretch a window across several areas. PowerToys Run is something like Spotlight on Mac. You can launch programs, make search requests, and even solve math problems. I also sometimes use Text Extractor to copy text from pictures, interface elements, and basically any places where you can't copy the usual way. And that's it, guys. Simple, takes just a couple minutes, and no hassle. The load on the system barely changed, and considering our small improvements, there are fewer processes running in the background. I also want to remind you, if you want to add a cool cursor to your setup, the best ones are collected in the Secret Links Telegram channel. That's all, thanks for watching. Don't hold back on your likes and subscriptions. Good luck to everyone and bye.